Yo, what's going on, fam? It's your boy Humble here, bringing you a brand new upload. And today we're going to be going over how to gain up to 3,000 arena points a day. I've been playing a ton of arena the last couple weeks, worked myself over 22,000 points. And I think that puts me in a good position to give you guys some really good tips today about how to gain arena points fast, how to gain a couple thousand a day. Just make sure y'all watch this video all the way through for the absolute best tips, the absolute best results. Make sure y'all drop a sub with the noties on. Thank you so much for 50,000 subs, man. Much freaking love. Also, guys, I live stream on Twitch. You can check the link out in description if you want to say hi to me live there or ask me questions there. But without further ado, let's get into this video, how to gain up to 3,000 arena points a day. Let's go, baby. All right, guys, the first topic that I want to cover when going over arena points and trying to push points in arena is asking yourself a really important question. Are you comfortable fighting the people in your arena at your point level with equal guns and equal loadout? Or are you guys finding yourself really struggling in head-to-head fights against people who have the same or similar weapons? No third party, you're just losing a lot of fights. If this is the case, the first thing that you guys have to do is become way better box fighters. You need to hop into box fight fills. You need to box fight good friends or good teammates that you have and build up that confidence. You need to train your aim if that's what's lacking. Basically, what I'm telling you is you need to become a more confident and better fighter all around if you're going to be able to compete in arena at a high level. Now, if this isn't your issue and you guys are finding more of a problem with getting third party, bad timing, you guys are dying off rip too much, you're not landing well or finding good spots, you're not playing the right game modes, you're tilting, tons of different things, right? But if you're consistently losing fights in your arena, you need to W key and just get a lot of fights in and not worry about points until you feel like you're a confident fighter at that level. It is not worth pushing up and just camping the whole game to slowly squeak points up. The only way to really gain these big point quantities day in and day out is to become a confident player. You have to believe in your gameplay. You have to believe you're a better fighter than the person across from you consistently. Otherwise, you're not going to see the big point growth that you're looking for. Don't waste your time. But if that's not you, if you're still looking at this video, let's go. Let's get into the arena tips, man. Let's push your points. All right, guys. So the first major recommendation I have for pushing points is you're going to want to find a duo that you have really solid chemistry with, maybe two or three different people that you switch out with, if depending on who's on or whatever, but you don't want to do anything else besides grinding out these duels. Don't get stuck playing solos because number one, it's going to be way too boring for most of you. Obviously, there's certain exceptions, but solos, you're not going to be able to play the same consistently because A, you're either getting tilted, which I do really, really bad when I'm alone and I'm getting third partied and I have no one to help. Solos also has by far the lowest skill gap. There's so much RNG involved in a one-on-one fight that there's not once you put two people into the mix, because then you can start game planning, pressuring, and playing off of each other, which adds a whole nother layer of Fortnite that I really enjoy. Also, just having a teammate makes the game way less boring for me. I have a lot better time, which keeps me focused, keeps me from tilting, all those things. So I definitely recommend you could also play trios, whatever you guys are interested in. That's also what FNCS is for this year, so that's always very good to practice fighting threes. Either way, guys, you want to be having teammates, going to keep you from tilting, going to keep you focused while you're on your playtime, which is also very important. You guys don't just want to get on and play to play, because when you're, you know, halfway going or you're halfway set, you're not really paying attention, focusing, locked in, you're not going to get the points going up. You're going to tilt. And the biggest way to lose points and not gain them is by dying off rip, tilting, going one death after another, burning games without thinking about it. You guys need to really pay attention to your games. Even if you're just gaining a little bit of points every game, as long as you're not having these big tilt moments, you're going to find yourself gaining a lot of points in arena, man. The big problem comes in when you're churning your wheels. You win a game, then you'll die off rip twice. Then you'll win a game, you're not focusing, right? You're being very off and on. You can't have that nonchalant stuff. So that's tip number one. The next major tip that I want to get into is making sure that you are properly warmed up when you're getting into your arena cycle, when you're getting ready to play the day out. Basically, a really good way to look at this is, have you guys ever played through a full tournament, like really focused, you do decent in the tournament, and then you guys go into arena after putting in all that focus and being very, very warm and focused? What do you guys do? You play really, really confident. You play really good in arena because you just sweated out a tournament. All the endorphins are going, the adrenaline's going, the focus is out, you're making good comms, you're playing confident. You just got through a 3-hour tournament, the best warm-up possible, right? If you guys treat your warm-up for arena for the day anything like how you guys treat a tournament day, you are going to perform in arena 2-3 times better, guaranteed. Practice how you play, guys. I promise you, you will see huge returns even in your tournament gameplay just by playing arena in this manner. All right, another big thing that I want to talk about that really hinders a lot of people's arena growth and just growth in general on Fortnite getting better is they don't comm. They do lazy communication with their duo or trio, especially in arena when they're playing it half-minded, you know, they're half in, half out, like we were talking about. Basically, you're getting in on fights without saying anything. You're not communicating. You're not pulling back when your duo needs to heal. You're not getting up with your duo when healing. You're not playing with him. You're just playing lazy. You're trying to get in there and be the hero in 2v1 over and over. This is not a consistent way to play the game unless you're in the top 1.1111% of players, right? Unless you're one of the best is what I'm trying to say. Guys, most of us aren't one of the best. You need to play with your duo, play off your duo, especially as you start to push up into Division 7, 8, 9, 10, all that stuff. You guys are not the best in the world. You need to humble yourself, play with your duo. Anybody needs to do that, right? It's not just about like, you know, an ego chow or am I saying you're bad? No one's going to do good in 2v1s consistently, right? So you need to learn how to be patient, because really the name of the game when it comes to pushing up arena points, like we've been talking about, is a minimizing dumb quick deaths. The more times that you guys are making it into that top 25 placement, every single time you do that, that's a positive for that game. That means you're coming out of that game with more points than you came in it with. And every single time those lazy deaths go by and you don't even think about them, right? They add up. You kind of forget about it. You think you're doing decent that day, but you forget about, oh, I got in alone. I ran without my teammate and pushed a 2v1 and died real quick and we got wiped. Your brain's forgetting about those quick ones, and that's why your points are going up the way you expect them to when you check your points at the end of the day. You probably think you're up 600-800 points, then you're like, oh my gosh, we've only gained 100 or lost 100. We're almost even. That's why we're not going anywhere. You're not making every single life precious and valuable when you're playing the game. And yes, this sounds extreme, right? But if you guys really want to push points, that's the way your mindset has to be for most players. All right, guys, and sticking with the theme of consistency here, the next thing that I want to talk about is finding a consistent landing spot and learning all the little things about it. Learning how to drop it is the most important thing of them all. Learn how to be first drop every single time at one or maybe two spots, depending on what kind of bus, if you want to adjust to different buses. But it is so important that you're consistently getting first drop from all angles, right? Basically, that's probably the most RNG way, or the way to die off spawn in general, is just dying off rip because of a bad drop or a poor drop. So make sure that you guys find a couple spots and really take the time to learn how to get that first drop on that area. Watch pros who land in that area, see what they're doing from different angles. That is definitely by far the best way. Also, you can go into Battle Lab and just practice landing there and just going over and over again, respawning, and then you can kind of get a feel for how to land at a certain area. Very important that you take the time to do that. The next thing you want to learn, obviously, is where every single chest spawn is. If you guys are just landing places, you know, just willy-nilly on a whim, you're going to be dying a lot because A, you don't know where all the chest spawns are, so you're not going to be getting your loot fast enough. You don't know where all the ground spars are. You're not getting first drop. You don't know how to fight or where third parties and chokes usually come into in a certain area. It's very important to know where you're landing, how to use the gold there, how to do the tasks for the gold there, that the AI, all these different things, right? Know where you're landing, know how to drop, know how to dominate the area you're landing. It's going to minimize the amount of times you die off rip by a lot. Trust me, guys. I like to land Slurpee or Caddy Corner. With Colazo winning now, it's a little bit packed at Caddy, so we've been landing Slurpee a lot more. But yeah, those are the main areas that I like to land personally. And the next thing I'm going to be talking about is something that is new to this season of Fortnite, and that is utilizing gold every single game. Basically, all gold is, if you want to think about it in a really good way, is it's just something, it's a tool, right, to minimize RNG, to minimize random luck within Fortnite, which is super important for a battle royale with as much luck as Fortnite has. Basically, what gold does, if you properly use it in arena, every single time, it can either be getting your guns upgraded, it can be giving you way more shield to carry, it can be giving you peppers to rotate and get out of bad third parties, tons of different things that are going to improve your gameplay, and pretty much every single AI has useful tasks and useful things you can buy with the gold. And you guys probably want to base your landing spot at a place that has a gold upgrade for guns, or one of the AIs is nearby at a POI that's two or three POIs away that you can rotate to depending on zone. It is so important that you guys do this and plan your arena games out like this, because gold is probably the best way right now in Fortnite to minimize your RNG, just like how upgrade stations were last time. And I know a lot of you guys are probably lazy with your gold and you're not always thinking about it and thinking about doing all the tasks right when you land and getting bounties early. It is super, super important. You can also duel a ton of the AIs to to get P90s. You can get purple AKs from the one at Caddy. It's Slurpee, you can get the P90. At Misty, you can get the P90. So many different ones, right? There's so many good upgrade areas where you can duel for purple weapons. You can upgrade for purple weapons. You can buy shield, all these different things. You really, really want to keep focused on that. It's super, super important for keeping your RNG to a minimum when playing Arena over long periods of time. And yeah, guys, I really just want to emphasize the point from much earlier in this video. Some of you guys need to face the facts that you are not at a place yet where you can gain this amount of arena points. You're just simply not at the confidence and or skill level that it takes to really, really push arena, and that's fine. But don't overthink it. Don't always think it's something that you're doing wrong that you can change overnight. Sometimes you gotta put in work for a few months and get really good. And the best way to do that, right? How that all starts is by recognizing that you need to improve. Some people will play for days, weeks, months, and they just don't have that inner, you know, voice saying, hey, I'm not where I gotta be yet, and that's okay, I need to put in work. They think they're good where they're at, they're making tons of excuses, and they're not getting better. Don't be that person. They're the farthest person away on this chart from getting where they wanna get in Fortnite, man. Be honest with yourself about where you're at, and you will go by far the furthest over time. I promise, guys, it does not matter what your skill is now. Don't overthink it. Like I always like to say, focus on being better than you were yesterday, and I'm gonna end that video off with that. I really hope this arena video inspired y'all, helped y'all, maybe got y'all refocused on what you need to be focusing on and getting to in your gameplay. But yeah, man, make sure y'all drop a sub. Thank you so much for 50,000 subs. I hope you enjoyed this video once again. I hope you guys sub if you did enjoy. Have a wonderful day, man. Peace.